Hello and welcome back to the Royal Legion SMP series, where in this episode we are starting exactly from where we left off in the... Okay, almost exactly from where we left off in the last episode, where we built the potion brewing maker thingy 9000, I don't remember what I called it. I need to put a sign with the name up there. But yes, hello and welcome back to another episode. No, we have not done the Ender Dragon fight yet, but we're gonna be doing it soon. I know exactly when, but I'm not gonna spoil it for you, so you'll just have to wait to see when it will happen. But maybe next episode, who knows, if everything goes according to plan. Maybe I'm not guaranteeing it, but who knows. Anyways, in this episode, because we're gonna be doing the Ender Dragon fight very soon, we are gonna be doing a bunch of well, small stuff that needs to be done before the fight. So let's get started. Alright, so first I was told that spice mines have left something around here somewhere. Wrong button again. So I think the first thing is to find it. Yes, the chicken is still there. The spicy chicken is still there. There's a baby zombie coming. He's a bit creepy, but it's fine. I'll just get an arrow to the face. There we go. I'll take his flesh and his levels. Okay, so nothing official right here. All right. Close that. I'm assuming it might be upstairs then. Let's go and take a look. Also, we gotta fix the brewing machine. Actually, I switched the gunpowder with, I believe, the blaze rod around, so it was easier to get down here, so I could add the modifiers from down here, and then everything else would be down there. And do I have... I forgot to add an ingredient. Where do I have phantom membrane? There it is. Well, that's not much. I need to kill more phantoms. Okay, what am I doing here? You know what, let's just add the glass to this chest over here. Actually, no, not that chest. Let us add it to this chest up here. Right there. Yes, this is one of the things we will be doing. We will be adding a background to these and also a roof, hopefully, so it looks a lot better. And also we'll finish the floor and the ceiling and that wall over there as well, so it looks a lot better. And also I need to get a better furnace system going at some point, but for right now I want to find what spice mines have left. Let's just take a look at the tree farm. I don't know where he has left it. Maybe at the shop, maybe I'm looking at the wrong place, but it's looking pretty good. We got a lot of wheat as well, so we can get... what was that? Did you see something? I'm not sure, maybe I'm seeing things. But yeah, we got... did I not replant that tree? Apparently not. But everything seems to be going pretty good. We got plenty of wheat, so we got plenty of food as well, which is good. I'm not seeing anything currently. Nothing down here either. Let's check the nether portal, and if not the nether portal, let's then go ahead and check the shop and see if there's anything over there. Also, actually, Spice Mines gave some suggestions to my shop. It is quite a long time ago, but I haven't gone around to do them yet. So we're gonna, yeah, take a look at the shop at some point as well. But let's go through here. Nothing. Well, let's go to spawn then. Let's go to the shop and see if there's anything over there. And if not, then I have no clue what to do. I have no clue what to do. Unless... oh! Okay, all the phantom membrane has been sold. Okay. I don't know if that's it. I'm guessing it is. Okay. People really like my guest here. That's good for business, apparently. I'm assuming that is what he meant. Wow. Okay, four diamonds and same gold. Nice. Thank you, Spice Mines. I'm assuming it's you, but thank you to whoever it is who bought those things. Very nice indeed. All right, so that means I have to restock on gas tiers again, doesn't Oof. I don't think I had any phantom membrane around here, did I? Except for the two in here. Okay. So we gotta get that going. Let's just put that in this slot right there and then go around to the machine we made last time and where is it? This one. There we go. Boop. There we go. Yeah, I do want some potions for the dragon fight, such as instant health. So if we just make a few more of those. Also, I found a flaw with this, or not really a flaw, but a thing to note. Because the lever is here, it is turning this hover off. So unless we flick it or switch it, it will then transfer the bottles over. But as long as it's on, which means the system is disabled, it will not be transferring the water bottles, which is fine. All right, so we want nether wart going down there. We want glycerine melon and then redstone and then gunpowder. Like that. Hopefully that comes down in the right order. Boom, nether wart. You see, that's a problem. Because, see, the problem was I hit the nether wart, then hit that, and then immediately went down and hit the redstone. I need all these modifiers to be way in the back down here. Because otherwise it's not gonna work as it should. So you know what? Let's just quickly change those. This episode will be all about changing small things and stuff that needs to be changed. I'm sure I heard something. So let's move all that back down to the other end. And boom, boom, and boom. All right. Perfect. Because now that ensures that the gunpowder and the redstone and the glowstone will always come in the end. Why did I think redstone? Why did I think redstone? I'm not sure. Let's resend that down. Glowstone and gunpowder. There we go. You know what? I should probably have some sort of sorting system back here. So when I have a bunch of potion ingredients, I could just put it in a chest or a hopper and it will be sent down here. That's something to work on when I have more iron. Again, I need a lot more iron to do that. All right, perfect. So let that go. I have a huge problem. My chest plate is about to break, and I could repair it. I didn't actually think of this. I could repair it. But how much would that be? Is that too bad? It is a pretty good chest plate, I mean. But still, three diamonds. Actually, that's not too bad for a almost brand new chest plate. But I'm going to go ahead to the Emerald Emporium, which I hope I said that right, which is a place spice mines made for trading with villagers. If we go over here and with it at the giant emerald, and we take this book, Emerald Emporium, trading post. Now open, bring all of your extra materials and trade them for the emeralds you could ever want. Then trade those emeralds with the villagers for items from their vast selection of enchanted weapons, armor, and tools. Ender pearls, glowstone, food, and much, much more. Free admission. To get to the Emerald Emporium, go through the nether portal here at spawn and follow the signs. So I think we're gonna do that. I may or may not have. I don't really have that many materials, but I can trade for emeralds. And also, he told me that there's a farm that we can use over there to get the emeralds. So, Yeah, that is probably gonna work out just fine. As long as I just don't, well, completely empty out a trade. So gotta be careful about that. Back here, so that's Mr. Grunt's base. Let us go to. Nope, that's Paradise base. Okay, perfect. Let's go this way and I'll be back at Emerald Emporium. Finally here. That took quite a bit to get here, but I really like this tunnel with the walls and stuff. It looks really, really nice. Now, I've already been here before, so I believe it is Spider-Man's Emerald Emporium. Yeah, this over here. Past the pigment and right through the tunnel. Sorry, the portal. Let's take a look. I'll have my sword out just in case. Not expecting anything, but you know. Alright, welcome to Emerald Emporium. Please read. Alright, I'll read. Let's take a look.
Welcome to Emerald Emporium. I hope you enjoy your stay. While you're here, there are a few rules. 1. Please try not to leave any locked trades. If you have a locked trade and cannot unlock it, please notify. Alright. 2. Please replant any crops that you harvest. If you run out of crops to plant, there are extra crops in the chest in the house next to the sugarcane patch. If you do not want to keep your leftover crops, feel free to put them in that chest. Alright. Please repair any damaged farmland with the hose provided in the chest in the house next to the sugarcane patch. If there are no hose in the chest, please notify Spider-Mines. Alright. Feel free to use the anvil at the blacksmith building. If the anvil breaks, please notify Spider-Mines. Also, feel free to use the furnaces at the blacksmith building. Coal is provided. Please notify Spider-Mines if there's no more coal. Feel free to use the enchantment table in the central two-story building. There is a chest with 3 lapis lazuli for you to use. If you have any extra lapis you want to get rid of, feel free to add it to the chest. There's also an additional chest at the enchantment table where you can drop off any unwanted enchanted items. These items will be free for anyone to take and use. Feel free to use the brewing stand in the basement of the building next to the second-story building. If the brewing stand needs fuel, take the chest in beside it for blaze powder.
Okay, I think I got all those instructions. Problem is, it's now nighttime, and I have no bid. Alright, just want to make sure that it's safe. Alright, so. Whoa, okay. Huh. Wow. I gotta say, this place is beautiful. Alright, so. There's a lot of villagers here. Was that a wolf? Yeah, that's a wolf. Okay, so some of them. Oh boy. Okay, you know what? Let me just turn those sounds down for you. That's a bit loud. Alright, so some of them have names, as you can see. And I'm looking for a specific one, though it might be hard to find the guy that I'm looking for. Oh, there's a bed in there. I can sleep. And just. Ooh, and a chest. Okay, perfect. Do I have a bed in here? I actually do have a green bed. You know what? I'll use my own bed. Oh, not that. Don't want the helmet. I'll just quickly place the bed. Sleep. Break it and put it back in, and I need to see the name of the villager that I'm looking for. So I'll be right back. Alright, so apparently the guy's name is Lawrence. Hopefully I spelled or yeah, pronounced that correctly. Pub. Lawrence. Lawrence. Philip? Nope. Lawrence? 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 Nope. No Lawrence here. Pub cleared. Lawrence! There he is. Let's take a look at what he's got. Protection 2. That's a lot for just a diamond chest plate. Do we have any other blacksmiths who give sim. Oh. That's not too bad of a sword. One emerald. Oh, 4 emeralds for an ender pearl. Okay. Well, these guys have a lot of. Ooh. Oh, that's expensive. I don't have that many emeralds. I might have in the future, but currently I do not. Okay, so 16. Was it 16? I think it was 16. Or was it 12? 16 emeralds for a diamond chest plate with protection 2, or 4 emeralds to protect my repair my current one. I mean, I have way more diamonds than I have emeralds. I think I'm just going to repair it, to be honest. But I definitely wouldn't mind at some point trading with these fellas to get something like this. But also just to get emeralds. That wouldn't be bad. So I think I'll probably come back here and, yeah, doing some trades, because I do want some emeralds. I don't have any at the moment, except for 8, I think. So yeah, I'll definitely be back. But I gotta say, this place is looking really cool. Even though I'm not gonna be doing any tradings with these guys, this place is looking amazing. I had no idea it was like this. Way more awesome to see it in person. Do we have a mending book? Frostwalker. That's a nice book. 64 emeralds, still. Alright. Not bad. Map of the surrounding area. Alright. I'm not gonna be wasting any more of this video's time, though I could be running around here looking at everything the entire day. But I'm gonna go back. I think I've gotta repair my current chest plate. And, well, I'll get back to you on the next thing we should be doing. So, I'll be right back. Let us go ahead and start changing this floor. This will probably be one big time lapse where I fix the roof and everything. So, yeah. See you at the end of this. Time lapse starting in 3, 2, 1. We'll be right back. All right, phew, finally done with this section of the base. So far, so good. Huh. Those are not very, very long in their time. Did I forget to add redstone? I might have forgotten to add redstone. Let's see if it's possible. I wanted to make slow falling potions because that could be handy to have at end cities and also in the Ender Dragon fight itself. So that's something useful. And I just did it again, didn't I? Yeah. Okay, well, that's my only phantom membrane. But so far, I have added the floor, I've added the ceiling, and I've added the ceiling over here as well. I think I'm gonna add some... Well, my main goal is to actually put sea lanterns down here in the logs to hopefully... I think that's the block that fits the best, not these torches. I will continue down there. Oh, look at this. Oh, I gotta try this from a high place. How long does this last? 1 minute. I gotta hurry. Gotta hurry over here. Gotta hurry. I wanna see this in action while I still have it. Come on. Quickly. Quickly. Yay! Oh, that's cool, actually. Floating. That's cool. Alright, well, I think that will do it for this episode. I think I got everything done I wanted to do. I do want to restock my shop, but I think I'll do that in another episode because this is kind of getting long. So hopefully it'll probably be like 25 minutes or so. So yes, I hope you enjoyed. If you did, remember to leave a like, comment, and share it with your friends. And if you're new to the channel, remember to subscribe. This potion is awesome. And yeah, join my Discord server, link down below. And yeah, hope to see you next time and hope you enjoyed. Have a nice day. We gotta do something here in probably not the next episode, but probably in the next episode. Who knows what it will be. But anyways, hope you enjoyed and hope to see you next time. Have a nice day. Bye bye.